Hello everyone and welcome back to Front of House Structure. This month, I want to focus on poetry. Now, it might sound nuts, but let me explain to you what poetry is first of all and how we can use it in a restaurant. Now, poetry is any grouping of words that are put together in order to change your emotions. And there's all different forms of poetry all over the world. There's haiku, there's prose. Shakespeare used poetry and everything that he did. And in Shakespeare, you don't even have to understand what's going on. If you have a good Shakespearean actor, just the way they use those words and the way they change their voice, they can draw you in. Now, I want to show you how you can use this type of poetic thinking to make sales and to make huge sales. Now, I'm going to describe for you two different dishes, all right? Now, the first dish I'm going to describe has better ingredients. It seems certainly a lot more interesting. And it's probably more appealing to the mainstream guest in any moderate to upscale restaurant. The second dish is going to be something that's very simple, very plain, very boring, but I'm going to make it sound really good. And by making it sound good, hopefully I'm going to make your mouth water a little bit. You can use this information to make your guest mouth water a little bit, and you can break them out of their comfort zone. You can get them to trust you a little bit more because of your food knowledge, but you can also give them a reason to spend a little bit more because now you've made a dish sound great. Let me show you what I mean. What we have here is wasabi-crusted seared ahi tuna. It's being served over peanut and pineapple fried rice with a little braised baby bok choy and a ponzu sauce. Now that sounds very good, doesn't it? Now I've described to you the dish, I've described to you what it is, I've described to you how it's cooked, but I haven't put any charm into it, I haven't put any pizzazz, I haven't given my guest a reason to buy that dish. Let me describe the second dish for you, and you'll see what I mean. What we do here is we take two slices of stone-ground wheat bread, brush them very lightly with lightly salted Vermont butter, and then we fill it with a rich and creamy Wisconsin American cheese. A slice of Lucky Tomatoes, which is a farm hothouse tomato from Florida, goes right in there. We take the whole thing and we sear it a la plancha on our hot griddle until the exterior becomes golden brown, has just a little crispness to it for an absolutely fabulous texture. Then we plate it with very thinly sliced russet potato chips that have been dusted with sea salt and a little bit of powdered white wine vinegar. It's a grilled cheese and tomato sandwich, but I've taken that grilled cheese and tomato sandwich and I've put poetry to it. I've made it sound great. I've made it sound irresistible. And to a guest, all they are thinking is, oh, I gotta have that grilled cheese sandwich because I made it sound that good. Now, you can take every single dish in your menu and describe it that way. And you should be able to describe every single dish on your menu that way, but that's not what we're about. We're about sales, remember. So what I want you to do is I want you to take, once you have this information in your head, I want you to take this information and use it in ways where you can steer your guests into buying what you want. Now, when it comes to my restaurant, again, people laugh because they say I tell them what to get. I tell my guests, in fact, what to order, and that's not true. But my goal is to make sure that my guests already have it in their head what they want to eat before they even open the menus. Now, if you use our icebreaker technique from a couple months past, you're already going to know how to start a conversation about food. This is where you use this poetry to land your sales. When you are suggesting your appetizers, pick the appetizer that you want to sell that makes you the most money and describe it with this poetry. And then take an entree that you want to sell and describe it with this poetry. And you're going to land those sales because your guests are now going to feel comfortable with you that you have this food knowledge, but subconsciously they're also going to crave this dish. Even if it's something that they don't normally order, you're going to make it sound too good to resist. This is how you land great sales. Now you can use this also, and you should be using this in your dessert descriptions, in your wine descriptions, in your cocktail descriptions, in your liquor descriptions. If you have two different alcohols and somebody's in between them, by all means, tell them, you know, this has more botanicals. This is distilled 5 times instead of 3. It's a lot smoother. It has a lot better finish to it. It's not as sharp, not as bitter. Find ways to use this verbal poetry to land those sales. You're gonna have a lot more success selling what you want to sell. You're gonna wind up taking orders a lot faster because if you land at a table right when they sit down and dive right into those menus and start using these descriptive words in order to get these people thinking about food, first of all, they're gonna start looking at the menus and order them faster, but they're gonna order what you want them to get, and that's our entire intention with this. Now, if a guest comes to you and says, you know, I can't decide between the tuna and the salmon. Which one would you choose? Here's what you say. And obviously you want to sell whichever one is more expensive. You say, well, the tuna is delicious, but the salmon, absolutely beautiful. It has a little horseradish crust to it, which gives just a little bit of sharpness, a little bit of heat, and then the chef sears it to give it a beautiful texture. It's served over a 7-grain medley that's a mixture of couscous and quinoa and rice, whatever it is. The point is, use that verbal poetry to sell that dish. That's what a great salesman does in any business. And now I've taught you how to do it. Take this skill, go out there and make those sales. Your check averages are going to jump and you're going to make a lot more money, and your guests are going to be a lot happier with you. Thanks very much. Tune in next month.